Greetings, fellow pilots. CD here with video number 2 in my advanced BF3 jet discussion series. Today we're going to focus mostly on effective spotting and air-to-ground combat. So let's dive right into some of the videos recorded from today's missions. This is day 7, learning to fly in BF3. So yeah, this one's kind of a gift. Take off and there's a jet right in front of me already marked. But I'm going to lose that mark. First thing I'm going to do is put that back. I'm telling you people, hit that Q button. Spot, spot, spot. Oof, for that turn. But yeah, the front kills are one of my favorites. Or at least in a stable. And then finish them off, of course. But yeah, I do enjoy killing from the front. If you can get them on the first pass, get them out of the way, free to do what you need to do. Hopefully they haven't spotted you yet, so you're not lit. And speaking of spotting, this is a blind spot. You know, I didn't see anything down there. I just figured something was near that spot. I'm telling you, you know, in a jet, especially, if you've got no target, just throw out a random cue. You never know what you're gonna find. So blind spotting is great and all, but you're definitely going to have to learn how to use all the abilities in this game to learn how to effectively spot. And even though this upcoming kill is not necessarily a ground target, it started on the ground. It might be hard to see, but I just spotted a jet taking off from the runway there. Now, it didn't show up as an actual spot just yet, because if you've played Battlefield for, you know, more than a day, you realize that spotting doesn't always work. There's distance issues, there's spamming issues, etc. But I did see this guy pretty damn low, and it led to a great kill right there from, you know, quite a distance. And that was all thanks to free look, which we're going to be talking about quite a bit today since it's so crucial to air-to-ground combat, and all combat really. But first, let's talk about approach. You see here, I take a look at the battlefield, and there's nothing marked, so what I don't want to do is go flying blindly right over the damn thing. Instead, what I did was I angled my jet upward, and I used right mouse button to use free look and looked right, spotting this target down below. Now, something I want to mention is that when you're doing this, if you've got other jets up in the air, especially ones that are following you, it can be quite dangerous to sit still while you're sitting there free-looking. So what you might have noticed is that I've switched over to using air radar down on the bottom left, which is much better at keeping track of various air targets and whatnot. So not only is it great for dogfighting, but I feel it allows me to play air-to-ground combat much safer, much easier, so I don't have to worry as much about what might be behind me. And as a result, here I am again, making another quick disable pass and putting free look again to good use. I know what you're thinking, another stupid button I'm going to have to use in the air, but it's really not that bad. I remapped mine from right mouse button to left shift. I just found it easier to leave on my left hand, and I'm only 2 days in and it's already become second nature. Now I just wanted to take a second to thank everyone for the comments about using the keyboard to fly instead of the mouse. But I just made that kill with the mouse, and I don't think I could have done it with the keyboard, at least not me. It's just personal preference again, no love lost, I prefer the mouse. Now that said, I know my aim has taken a hit, but my progress from day 5 even to day 7 has been pretty good, except for right here. Spotting obviously makes shooting targets easier, but what I should have been doing here was using the actual icons to my advantage. I should have had the gun a little bit further right between the actual tank icon and the star. That's usually the ideal spot to shoot when you can't make out the exact target. This is certainly true for choppers, and it's a good thing to remember, because if you're like me and you gave up heat seekers, you've found that shooting choppers is not as easy as you might think with the gun. Their direction changes are often frantic, and you can't always tell what direction they're facing from distance. Just barely got him, but it almost cost me my life since I almost stalled there trying to get him. And that's something you gotta work on too, is knowing when to give up on a target, something that's gonna come up next. So I'm back in the air, scanning, and I see this tank and decide to head over. And I'm going to throw out my usual, which is starting with a rocket barrage, followed by the guns. That way, if I do miss, I can usually get rockets off again. And I see him going for that overpass, so maybe I'll get rockets again when I started taking fire. Second set away, and I got that disable, but ultimately it cost me my life. Alright, enough about my failures. Let's talk about what you guys came here to see, which is air-to-ground combat. And like everything else you've seen up till this point, it's all captured off of one day's worth of missions. So there's really no cherry-picking going on other than picking, you know, the best fights or matchups out of those videos. And, you know, I get requests all the time to do full match uploads, and probably will at some point, but my 10-0 or 13-0 matches don't really matter at this point. You can get a good sense that these things work in battle without having to see that kind of stuff. Now that said, everything you're going to see from this point on is from just two different rounds, one of which being Karg Island and the other one being Operation Firestorm, so you get a pretty good sense of what an average, you know, map or round is once you've got some of these basics intact. Anyway, here we are on Karg Island, and as with any map, knowing your surroundings is beneficial to survival. And this one's no exception in that half the map is effectively gone for cover since it's just water. You know, you're much easier to be spotted over water by aircraft and enemy AA, so you gotta know that you're gonna be in the thick of it on this map. Especially with the two airstrips being so close to one another. So take this into account when you're choosing your loadouts. You might decide to go stealth instead of air radar, stuff like that. Now on this approach, I didn't get a free look spot. Instead, I'm keeping my reticle over near their base, and sure enough, on a random Q spot, I got that tank. So that's another thing where knowing your surroundings, you know, making educated guesses can really help you when it comes to finding ground targets. Now since we're talking about random spots again, I should go over one other thing. You know, the further away you are, the more you've got in your reticle, and the more that's likely to get spotted. So on this particular pass, I'm pretty damn far away, and I just hit it, and sure enough, it lights up a mortar. Now normally I won't go out of my way to kill infantry, but mortars are a special case. They're usually far away from your teammates, a little bit harder to spot, and they do some pretty serious damage, especially on rush maps. So at least mark them and try to take them out if you can. So we're still here on Karg, and you know, I know this is mostly about ground combat, but I don't want you to think for a second that there won't be any jets around. You're gonna still have to clear the skies before you can make runs on the ground, especially if there's competent pilots in the air. But the second they're down, it's same old back to business. I'm gonna get up in the air, try to angle myself a little bit away from the base, and hit my right mouse button and do my free look, and bam, there's a bunch of targets again. So it's time for another dusting of rockets. Crooked rockets this time as I'm drifting a little bit, but no matter, worked out just fine. So here's another example of a hot zone. This time it's Operation Firestorm, and I've got tones going off all over the place, jets to deal with, and my squad's under mortar fire. So as soon as that jet goes down, I know I've got at least 45 seconds till he even spawns. So I get my nose up, do my spot, coming around for another pass, and lucky enough, they actually spotted the mortar, so I'm going to take him out right away. And there we go. The immediate danger is taken care of, so I can get safe and come back around and do some more support. Alright, so let's talk some more about Operation Firestorm here while I take out this chopper. Unlike Karg Island, you do have lots of cover here. Lots of little ridge lines on both sides, ridge lines behind ridge lines, you name it, you've got it. So the thing to remember is to use them when you can. There's definitely going to be times when you're too high or you're doing something stupid like chasing an empty jet over the middle. But even if you have flares or ECM jammer and other countermeasures, the time's going to come where it's not going to be enough, and you're going to need to know the terrain around you, where it is, and line of sight from it so that you can effectively use it. And if you're somebody who's given up flares and ECM for fire extinguisher, let's say, you're definitely going to have to learn the terrain and what's around you, because you're going to have to rely on that to get away from stingers and other missiles and whatnot. If you're having a hard time actually getting some flying time together so you can learn the map, something you can do is use the server browser to your advantage. First off, just limit the servers to Caspian, Operation Firestorm, and Karg Island. Set it to Conquest. And what you're going to want to do is type in the search bar the word start. That will help you find a ton of servers that have a one or two player start, so you can find the empty ones and have nobody there, and you can fly around in jets and mess around and do whatever you need to do. So as we bring this discussion to a close, I thought I'd finish with a nice little run of three tanks in a row here, and then I'd discuss some of the things involving tanks specifically. first and foremost, it's really not that easy to take a tank out in one pass, despite what the video here is showing you, at least as you're learning. It's going to take some practice, just like everything else, but there are a lot of variables involved here. You've got things like armor perks that they might have, which is going to make it a little harder to kill them. You've got to deal with the angle of the tank. You know, this is a battlefield game and it's relatively realistic, and if the tank is facing you and you're shooting machine gun fire into the front of it, it's going to handle that a lot better than it would if it's being shot in the back. You might also only be getting a bunch of splash damage when you're shooting rockets at them as opposed to hitting them directly, giving you this false sense that you're actually doing a ton of damage to them. In addition to that, you have to worry about engineers, one or more possibly, that could be in the back sitting there repairing them while you're doing splash and gunfire damage into the front. This is a very real possibility and does happen quite a bit. So don't get discouraged if you're not taking them out in the first pass. It might take you a few times, especially as you're just learning. Then as your overall flight skills start to improve, you'll require less and less time and distance to actually get your ordnance onto the tanks and other vehicles. You'll start being able to do runs straight down on them and getting them where they have less armor, or maybe mixing in multiple targets. The final big point here I'm trying to make is that if you spend the time to get better at this, you will get better at this. The learning curve is a little steep when you first jump in, and if you don't know kind of what to do or where to go and what servers to find, it's a real pain in the ass. So hopefully these videos have made it a little easier to get in the cockpit and feel confident. So if these discussions have helped you out in any way, or you'd like to see more of them, be sure to leave a comment below, or at least hit that thumbs up button and let me know you enjoyed it. And I'll see you guys out on the battlefield. Actually, above the battlefield. Take care.